Hi guys! Today I will show you how you install the Rotavapor R-80. Here it is! Let's unpack this. So I unpack the box, and inside the box you find the R-80, a power cord, then we have the receiving flask, we have the vapor duct, in here is the condenser, we have the ball joint clamp for the receiving flask and the vacuum seal. Okay, so the first thing you do is you install the vapor duct. It comes with the CombiClip, so you just insert it here. And when you hear this click, you know you've inserted it correctly. Okay, so now that the vapor duct's installed, you can install the seal. Just take the seal with the adapter, apply even pressure, and take off the adapter. Okay, so then the next thing is the condenser. I'm actually gonna turn the R80 so you can see it better. Okay, so what you do is this part goes in here, and you just turn the flange not to secure it tightly. So, like this. So then, the next thing is the receiving flask. And we need this clamp here to attach it. So. So you just take the clamp and do it like this. So now you just connect the instrument to the power. So now we've installed the R80 and we can move on to the vacuum pump. So the first thing we do is we connect the navigation control onto the interface, and we're gonna put the interface we mounted onto the R80 interface using these screws. And we have the vacuum pump, V-180. We're gonna connect that to the power, and I will show you later how we connect the vacuum to the R80. So the first thing we do is we take out these two screws. Then we place the interface I-180 on top of this one. And we take the longer screws to place them back in here. So we also connect the pump to the power. And we connect the pump to the R80 with the Buchicom cable. These are the ones with the green parts here. So you go to the outlet that says COM here, and do the same on the R80. So now we're gonna mount the Woulff bottle onto here. This piece we don't need, that's only if we mounted it onto the vacuum pump. Just like this. And make sure that the pump, it says pump here, faces towards your vacuum pump. So now you take this hose and you cut it into three pieces. We recommend one length of 400 millimeters, 700 millimeters and 900 millimeters. So then you install the hose to the hose nipples. And from the condenser, you go to the inlet that has the one on the back. So I connected all the hoses. So just to recap, we go from in on the pump to the pump on the Woulff bottle. We go from connection one to the condenser, and from the interface up here, it's called Konter. Now the last thing we need to do is to connect the interface to the Rotavapor. So we again use the COM cable, we go to the part here, this. And also again down here to the other comb. Now the last thing we need to do is to connect the water, the cooling water. So then you take the cooling tube and you as well have to cut it into three pieces. We recommend two pieces about 1.5 meters and 1 5-centimeter piece. If you have a cooling water valve, you can connect it here. You connect it to your cooling water outlet. And then this piece, I already prepared it. You actually connect the cooling water sensor to here, and then you take the 5-centimeter piece and you connect it to the hose nipple. So then you take the same tube and you connect it to one of the outlets here. And you take a second tube that's also connected to a nipple and connected to the other one. And the end of this tube, you can just connect to your water outlet. So then you connect the water valve to the water sensor. And you plug in the cooling water sensor to the Rotavapor, here where it says CWT. And now you can organize all your tubes with the tube holders here. So just connect them here. So now that I've shown you how you install the R80, you are ready for your first installation.